Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Midland Community Stadium and MCTV for tonight's city championship football game. It's the Midland Chemics, the home team tonight, against the Dow High Chargers. Welcome, everybody. This is Dave Marsh bringing you the action, along with the old ball coach, Frank Aldemore. And as usual, coach, it's an electric atmosphere here in the stadium. There's no night like it, really.
Nothing like it all year, right. It's the biggest sports event in the city of Midland for the year. We're going to probably have between 10 and 12,000. The stands are pretty well packed as we go along. We have one area across the way, which is reserved seating. And there'll be the late shows in a couple minutes.
I saw them in the parking lot.
Yeah, they're still there. But it's going to be a great night. A lot of emotions tonight. Last city championship game for a lot of seniors. The last time a lot of seniors will be putting on their equipment and playing for their schools. Dow obviously is going to play next week in the playoffs. Midland's chances are very slim, even with a victory, because of the point structure. So this ought to be a great game, and we're going to see a lot of interesting plays being developed that have been saved probably all year for this game. So it's always exciting.
Yeah, Dow High coming into the game with a 7-1 record. Their lone blemish coming at the hands of Carmen Ainsworth last week. 5-1 in the Saginaw Valley League Blue Division. Midland High, meanwhile, 4-4, 4-2 in the Red Division. Midland looking for a victory tonight to clinch a winning record. And as we mentioned, this one's for the city championship. This is the 50th time Midland and Dow will have played each other. Three of those times have been playoff games, including last year. But the 50th meeting and the 47th city championship game. Wow, can you believe that?
No, considering I've only missed one of them on all these years.
Yeah, so always a fantastic night. And, there's still a lot on the line with the season as a whole, but it's in a way of like two seasons. You got your first eight games, and then there's the game. And so we will be here tonight, both teams all fired up, jacked up, ready to put on a great show for the crowd tonight.
This is always a special evening because no matter what happened during the season, this game is special. And you just wipe out the season and you play this game. And you hope to have your best, you play at your best in this game.
Absolutely. And look at the Midland High marching band down on the field. We'll start with the keys of the game and see what we have to look forward to tonight.
Okay, for Midland, they've got to score 30 points. Dow has scored over 30 points almost in every game but last week, and in that game they should have had 30 points. And so you've got to be able to put points on the board. Consequently, you've got to be able to limit Dow's possessions. The more times Dow has the ball, they will score. They will take advantage of your problems. And then in third part, Midland has a special team mojo. They are the best special team concept of probably any team in our league and maybe in the entire state. They do just a wonderful job of it. And so for Dow, they have to avoid turnovers. They have advantages, they gotta do them. They gotta be physical on offense and defense, and they have to make the best use of their big play offense.
All right, so we'll see how that all plays out here in the first half. And we look down on the field right now with the Midland High Marching Band as they are getting ready to perform our national anthem. The color guard, as you can see, is going to be carrying the colors out onto the field. Really a neat moment here with the color guard coming out. The marching band and all the fans standing at attention. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask at this time that you please stand. Gentlemen, remove your hats. Veterans offering the military salute. And join our students, parents, coaches, and guests in the performance of our national anthem.
Midland High marching band, as always, and we'll be treated at halftime with one of the neatest things we'll see all year is when the Midland band and Dow band both come on the field together and perform. Just really such a neat thing that we get to enjoy each year. As you mentioned, two teams coming in, Dow at 7-1, Midland at 4-4, Dow High led by their sensational senior quarterback, Bruce Mann. Mann completing 60% of his passes, 1,700 yards. Coach, 22 touchdowns, only 3 interceptions.
He's had a terrific year. But with every good quarterback, you have to have good receivers.
Yeah.
And Dow, that is what Dow presents the mismatch to everybody. They have 6'3" and 6'4" receivers for the second year in a row, different players. And those players, they do know how to catch the football. And they have this advantage over you because your defenders are anywhere between 5'7 and 5'9. So that's a big, big advantage for Dow and a big advantage for Bruce Mann to have targets that not only can catch the ball, but know what to do after they catch it.
Senior Brendan Cook, one of those at 6'4", leads the way with 33 receptions, 572 yards, and 7 touchdowns. Austin Stredney, 23 catches, 255 yards, and 3 touchdowns. Another one of those outstanding receivers. But we'll hear several names. Fabiano will be in that mix. And he's got a lot of weapons to throw to, and also a terrific running back. In Moise Guerrier, he's comes in with 550 yards rushing, 4 touchdowns, 6.3 yards per carry. On the,
I think that the thing about this, when you look at Bruce Mann, he's an old single wing tailback. Not only can he catch it, or throw it, but he could probably catch it too. But not only can he throw it, but he's an outstanding runner. He's he has 550 yards rushing, and also he's the punter.
Yeah.
So he's a triple threat player. That's old single wing tailback.
That's right. He can do it all, and he's been spectacular the last two seasons. Midland High will be quarterbacked by Cade Mettner, coming in with completing about 48% of his passes, 693 yards, 10 touchdowns, only 3 interceptions himself. So he's been done a good job of taking care of the football for the Chemics as well. We're about to get underway. Midland High kicking off to Dow. And it's one of those short kicks fielded at about the 25, and it'll be run out of bounds. Nice kick up by Gavin Archibald. Be no return. Dow will take over on the 25-yard line. That was Brennan Doyle who received it and then stepped out of bounds, and Dow will take over first and 10 at the 25.
See, that's a little bit of that special team mojo I was telling you about, the kickoffs, the excellent coverage, inability to return a kickoff. One of the biggest plays that I can always remember is a kickoff return. They just don't let you have one.
And so it'll be man in the shotgun. Spencer Stevenson, the running back behind him. Stevenson will take the carry, plows ahead. A strong run. He's just an outstanding player, brought down by number 51, Hunter Schneider, after a four-yard pickup. Spencer Stevenson, a terrific player. We'll hear his name on offense, but really it's defense where he really shines. One of the best linebackers you're going to find. He's again the lone setback. Receiver split wide right and left for man as he surveys the field. Another handoff to Stevenson. He's tripped up, but he's going to be close to the first down, and he will get it. Had to reach the 35, and he did.
Schneider Landis on the stop.
So Dow, with that explosive, multifaceted offense, just runs it right up the gut, the first two plays, and it results in a first down.
Well, they're going to force Midland to get out of pass defense and take and respect the run. Exactly. Midland's playing pretty much a spread defense right now. Two high safeties, two corners.
Guerriere this time with the carry and nothing doing. That is Vincent Walker. Vincent Walker, defensive end, and he wreaks havoc in other
teams. Yes, he does. Between Walker and Landis, the two outside players, it's going to be difficult to make yardage on that perimeter of plays.
At D-line with Walker, also, like you mentioned, Greg Landis, 56, Cam White, 64. Linebacking crew, Vaughn Walker, Martin Money, Hunter Schneider, Mitchell Reed, starting at linebacker. Second and long, man drops it. He's going to keep this time, but not much doing. Play was disrupted a bit with the low snap, and Ryan Sasitki, number 24, will bring him down. After a minimal gain, will bring up third and 15 for the Chargers. Sasitki and 23, Zach Servinsky, are the safeties. Cornerbacks, number 5, Chance Freed, and number 2, Vondre Warren for the Chemics. First big offensive play here, third and long. Kind of big for the Chemics to stop here. Stop Dow from getting a big play. Man back to pass under heavy pressure. Eludes the rush. Still looking downfield. Fakes the throw. Still on his feet. Fires. Incomplete. He just got rid of it. Intense pressure by the Midland pass rush. He got away from Walker. And then Landis putting the pressure on and just had to get rid of it. So great job by that Chemic defense applying the pressure.
That was outstanding, Dave. You know, they had good coverage downfield, and then they have pressure. You've got to be able to control Walker. He's going to be in your backfield all night if you don't.
Man is the punter. And
we lost the replay.
And so Midland defense holds on third and long. Dow will punt. Good punt. He tried to avoid the return of Chance Freed, who was a turner, but kind of a short kick, and Midland will take over with really good field position.
Now, you see, that was kind of interesting because Vincent Walker came in off the edge, eluded the blocker, and presented a problem to the kicker. Kicker ended up a little bit rushed. Ball goes out of bounds, and Midland has outstanding starting field position.
There's three plays in a row disrupted by Walker. And so now the Midland offense. Cade Mettner, the junior, calling the signals as Andre Warren will take the handoff, goes off the left side. Picks his way ahead for about 3. There's a host of white jerseys bringing him down. Bring up a second and seven.
We're going to see a heavy workload out of Andre Warren tonight. He's been their workhorse all year long, inside and outside, but also he's a top receiver for them. And he's very dangerous in space.
Ethan Getgood splits wide to the left on second and seven. Mettner back to pass. Quick pattern, it's complete to Carter Grove. He's just a sophomore, and Midland will move the chains. We'll see if Midland tries to mix up the run with a short passing game. They did right there. Grove, a sophomore, get good at junior.
See, I think that's a good idea for Midland. Get some easy passes early, short, easy passes. Let the runner get the first down. Move the chains. Keep the ball in your hands.
Walker split wide to the left. Warren's going to take the handoff, go off left tackle, pick up about four.
Now, there's a formation we haven't seen all year. Two tight ends, one wide out, two backs.
Look for 21 Martin Money is one of those. Mitchell Reed, you'll see a lot of him, number one for the Chemics as well. He's at the left tight end. Two tight end set again for Midland. Warren doing a nice job. They kind of ran that belly. Took Mettner a long time to decide what to do with it. He hands it off, and it's going to go down to the Dow High 40-yard line, bringing up a third and two for Midland. Warren on the carry.
Again, I really like what Midland is doing right now. They have slowed the game down. Remember what I told you, one of my keys is limit Dow's possessions. Well, the way to do that is hold on to the ball in your possession.
Warren, Midland's leading rusher with 689 yards rushing coming in. Pitch right to Warren. Cuts up the field, he's got the first down. Oh boy, nice strong run. Brought down by Nick Siraki, but not before Midland picks up the first down to the Dow 36 yard line. 34, Vaughn Walker checks into the game, he's a junior. They're putting Money in the backfield. It's more almost effectively like a tight end in the backfield.
Exactly. Well, referred to today as an H-back.
Yep.
H-back type player.
90, Trey Childrey also in. He's a sophomore. Full house backfield on first and 10. And Vaughn Walker carries it for about three. Michael Bricall in on the stop.
Michael Bricall on the stop.
He's a senior, defensive back.
Gain of three by Walker.
Look for Brennan Doyle in the backfield, along with Bovee, Bricall. Second and seven for Midland. Andre Warren again spins and spins again. Finally brought down by Kevin Murray, number 77, but he's going to pick up about three. And this is old style three.
Be happy with 3 yards
in a
cloud
of dust.
Of dust
right now.
If we had to field that dust, you'd have dust. We've had
3 yards in a cloud of
rubber
pellets.
Pellets, yes. But I like what Midland's doing. I like what their plan is.
It's going to be third and long four. Again, full house backfield. Warren Walker Money. It's the Money this time. He's going to try to get the edge. He does. And Money takes off down the right sideline and goes in for the touchdown. Midland Chemics strike first. So they ran a heavy dose of Money being the blocker. And this time they faked the handoff, gave it to Money around the right end instead of the left. Broke a tackle and took it in for the score. Look at it again here. Kind of the quick
great
handoff.
Break, great break on the ball. And he just. Beautiful run here.
Went to get the edge. He was gone. Archibald misses the extra point. Oh, boy. So Midland strikes pay dirt, go up 6-0, missing the extra point. We'll see how that plays out as this game unfolds. But boy, in this early going, 5:13 to go in the first quarter, good defensive stand by Midland, and then
the
a great
good
drive.
Break, and then this is a poor tackle in space, and now money's around the corner, and there is no help. They're all gone.
Well, everybody went with the motion of the offense was left, which they had been running, and Money had mostly been the blocking back, but they kept that motion and did a quick handoff, and he went to the right instead.
Everybody went with Vondre Warren.
Yep.
Very, very good offensive start to the game for Midland High.
So Archibald will kick off for the Chemics. A little deeper this time, fielded at the 16. And Walker throws him down. That was Ben Zeitler on the return. We'll get out to the 27, but Vincent Walker with the big stick on special teams. Midland coaches discussing things. Yaki, one of the Midland coaches, in on the discussion. So Dow started with two runs last drive. See if they go to the air a little more. Nick Siraki in the backfield, along with Mann. Fakes the handoff. Mann's looking deep, and he's got his man. And there's the big play you were talking about. Dow's going to get a flag on that. Unsportsmanlike, but that's going to be
absolutely a
long touchdown of 73 yards to Joe Fabiano. In college, you don't score in that play if you do that.
A little bit of unnecessary hot dogging.
I don't know what the high school is. Let's look at it again.
It's a great pass. I mean, just a super
in
pass.
Stride.
Catches him. He's under coverage. Now he's got his legs underneath him. He's going to run in the end zone, and then he's going to taunt the Midland.
Yeah.
That's just. There's a spot on the bench for guys who do that, I have to tell you, because you hurt your team.
Unsportsman McCullen.
Unsportsmanlike conduct against Dow High.
They call it both ways. I'm not sure about that, but the point after will be attempted by Ashton Brooks. And extra point is up and good. And
good
Ashton
kick.
Brooks, who is also plays on the girls soccer team, she puts it through for the extra point, and Dow goes up 7-6. So turn the tables in a hurry.
That big play offense.
You called it on
you know,
the keys of the game.
One of the things you coach as you go along is you try to get them to be able to handle adversity. You know, a good play, you don't worry about it. You hope that the teams can turn the page. You can't bring it back. But we're looking at two teams that are really into it tonight. We'll see exactly what happens now as Midland answers.
Study and contrast in the offenses. Dow is going for the home run right from the beginning. Midland.
Well, this is exactly what I said in our keys of the game. If you're Midland, you got to score 30 points because Dow is going to score 30 points.
Right.
This could very easily be a game that is, you know, 42-38 if you're not careful.
Yeah.
Although, you know, you take a look at this. Dow is the number one defensive team in the league by 500 yards. Midland is ranked fifth. This is phenomenal for me. I couldn't believe it. Midland is ranked fifth in the league in defense behind, well, they're in fifth out of sixth.
Right.
So that's really a surprise for me. And you wouldn't know it because I think they're a good defensive team.
Dow will kick off from their own 25. Caleb Brudeau is doing the kickoff. 6'8" kicker. He's a senior. It'll be short kick handled by Get Good at the 36-yard line. Picks his way ahead, and it's going to be good field position for the Chemics at about the 44-yard line.
Now, this is the same field position that they had at the on their first possession.
I'm pretty sure we'll see more of the same with Midland trying to run the ball and chew up some clock. Keep that vaunted Dow offense off the field. Dow High with a pretty balanced attack, 1,410 yards rushing and 1,700 yards passing coming into the game. And the defense tops in the blue division, allowing just 1,596 yards so far this season. Dow outscoring their opponents 326-95. Warren the carrier. And tries to get by, but a really nice play out there by Connor Moe, the outside linebacker.
Well, here's the difference just in that first play from the first series. Dow, in the whole first series, was playing with their pads above Midland's pads. In that series right there, every single guy for Dow had their pads below the offensive lineman. And the difference is you get a half a yard.
On that D-line, Garrett Johnson. Lance Johnson will line up for Dow High on second and nine. Metner back to pass, rolls to the right, got good protection. He's going to tuck and run. Spins ahead, and he's going to get the first down into Dow High territory. Nice job by Metner. Once he decided to run, he ran hard, and didn't slide. He tried to get that extra yardage, and he's able to move the chains because of it. 51 Aaron Reardon. Shaken up a bit on that play. He's hobbling off the field.
Good play design. The linebacker had to pick up Walker coming out of the backfield, and when he did, the outside linebacker did not make the play.
So we'll line up like we did several times in that first drive. Money the H-back. Warren the carrier. Drives ahead.
Vaudrey Warren.
Brought down by Garrett Johnson, number 54. Gonna pick up about three and a half to go here in the first quarter. Dow on top, 7-6. Midland's had two possessions. Both have found their way into Dow High territory. Metner's going to keep it. This time he fumbles the ball, still on the turf, recovered by Midland. It's going to cost him a few yards. Big stick by Connor Moe. Popped the ball loose. Alert play by the Chemics.
Yeah, that would have been a big turnover right there. Very alert, picking up the play.
Ben Worley on the recovery. Johnny on the spot will bring up 3rd and 7. That could have been a disaster for Midland. See if Metner puts the ball up here. Virgil Walker, or Vince Walker, excuse me, split wide to the left. Metner back to pass. Under pressure, looking for Walker. Just a bit out of his reach. Got his fingertips on it, but unable to haul it in. And decision time here for Coach Metner. It's 3rd and 7 at the Dow 42-yard line.
Yeah, there's no decision here. The rule is if the ball's not inside the 40, we're punting. That's been always a standard rule. Try to put them as far deep in the hole as you can.
Ryan Coltson will do the punting duties for the Chemics. Meanwhile, Austin Stredney back deep to return for Dow. Good pressure. He's hit. And the kick is going to settle down at about the 4-yard line. Great job by Colston. He probably should have acted a little bit and gone down. He may have gotten a flag. was a little contact, but great job under heavy pressure. Dow will be deep into their own territory, starting at the 5-yard line. There's third possession of the game. Which in last, Midland defense stopped on their first, and then Dow went for the home run and connected on the long pass from Mann to Fabiano. Handoff to Guerriere, and he's going to be stopped. Maybe picked up a couple.
Vaughn Walker
and Martin Money in on the tackle for Midland High. Martin Money, outstanding athlete for the Chemics from an outstanding athletic family. Minute and a half to go here in the first quarter. Man hands it off, and he's brought down. A really nice play there by the Chemics as number 64, Cam White, tripped him up, and it'll bring up third down and seven. This would be a big play for that Chemic defense, Coach.
Yes, it would, because now you've got a punt from out of your end zone.
Almost guaranteed good field position.
Absolutely.
Whereas Dow, we've seen before, their offense, multifaceted. They just have a host of great plays to choose from. Man on the quick out. Well thrown ball, and he got his man. That's Brendan Cook on the catch. Great pass by Mann.
It was a perfect pass and a great pattern by Cook. Great pattern.
Quick out. It's almost impossible to defend that.
This is the thing. Midland is in that. They're in that press man, and you've got to worry about the bomb. So you're going to give them a little bit of room to allow them to maneuver. Those receivers can maneuver.
First and 10 from the 19. 20 seconds to go in the quarter. Hand off to Stevenson. He goes around the left edge. He's tripped up by Vaughn Walker, but he's able to stumble ahead for a few extra yards. Actually, pretty good job by Stevenson.
Stevenson's
there.
A hard runner. Two-way player, outstanding linebacker, bruising runner.
Yeah, he turned what looked like was going to be about a 2-yard gain into a 5-yard gain on the last play of the quarter.
Remember what we talk about, limit possessions. Keep the ball in your hands as long as you can. Midland's had two possessions, and this is Dow's third possession of the first half. Again, you're looking at, you know, Dow doesn't run a whole lot of plays. They run a lot of touchdown plays. So they'll probably run about 50 to 55 plays a game. You've got to be able to match that. You've got to have plays to match that.
So Dow High, besides the obvious city title on the line and Dow trying to secure a home playoff game, Dow has won the last three meetings, the last two city titles in 2014 and 15, and then won the playoff game last year. And so Dow looking to get their third straight city title for the second time in school history. Back to 95 through 97, which 3 years that I'm sure you enjoyed immensely. And so they're looking for the first 4-game winning streak here if they're able to pull this off here tonight.
Dave, I enjoyed every game immensely. I just enjoyed the ones we won a lot more. It's a long winter, I've got to tell you. It's a long winter when you lose this game.
Second and 5, Stevenson, the running back again. He'll take the handoff again. Uh-oh. Flea flicker, thrown deep, and it is dropped. Had his man. Great play, Austin Stredney. But you know, kind of threw, disrupted that play a bit was Walker.
Yes.
Man had to let go a little quicker than he wanted to and wasn't able to get it as much on the line.
You've got to be able to handle Vincent Walker. You've got to be able to handle him. Here he
comes.
In
and he just disrupted the throw.
Disrupted man a little bit, too.
Made him underthrow, but it could have been, it turned out to be a good thing. The receiver had to come back, but Stredney unable to haul it in. Bring up a third and five. Dow looking for the big strike again on that play. Fabiano, motion left. Man back to pass. That quick out again, and another perfect pass. And that
Stredney's
going to get the first down. So hard to defend that with a big receiver. You just run that out, and the ball is just a rock.
Right on.
Zipped right on
the money. It's right on the money.
What do you do about it?
You know, and that flea flicker, Walker was very close to getting a penalty. He was flying in the air. That's probably the only thing that saved him, is he launched and ends up hitting the quarterback after the ball was thrown, but it's in the process. So,
yeah. First and 10, Chargers from their own 35. Man's going to keep it. Scramble ahead. Good strong run by Man. Might have lost the ball. They're scrambling for it. I think it will remain Charger ball. I think one of the Midland runners tried to strip it from Man. Man's going to pick up 3.5 yards on the play. The Midland Sports Luncheon held this week over at Northwood. Really good luncheon, but you made a great point, Coach, about your best players need to play their best in the big games. And right now, Man is doing that.
Oh, yeah.
Second and six for Dow. Guerriere, Stevenson in the backfield. Man's going to keep it. Plows ahead. He's breaking loose. Still on his feet, sheds a tackler, another tackler, finally run out of bounds. But a great run. There's a late flag on the play. I don't know if Midland got a face mask or if we got a hold. Oh, it's going to be a hold on Dow. Could be one of those rare ones where they still get the first down.
I think
look again.
Going to be a little bit short of a first down. No, it is a first down.
Yep. So it's going to cost them the 10 yards, but they still move the chains. Ball just beyond the 45-yard line.
Still first down for Dow High.
See, this is what Dow does. They keep the ball. They get chunks of yardage. They run a lot of plays. And they wear you down. They're waiting to find out where they can attack you. You've got to be able to tackle in space, and you got to stop them on first down.
Guerriere takes a hand off this time, and a good tackle by Landis.
You can't run soft in there. If you watch Guerriere, he's running a little bit soft. He's looking for a hole. You got to be able to let your instincts take care of you. You cannot tell your feet what to do. Your eyes have got to do it for you.
Bring up a second and 9 for Dow. Again, Stevenson and Guerriere in the backfield. Man's going to keep it. It's like a little screen pass, possibly throws it away.
Passes it complete.
Call it intended for Fabiano, but I think Man was just trying to unload it. That play did.
Nice.
Was broken up
nice
right
defense.
From the beginning. Yeah.
Nice defense by Midland. One of those slow moving plays. Dow's much better. Snap the ball, set up, throw the ball. Midland's just going to eat up those play action because they're not concerned about them. They are only concerned with Man.
Man is a lot to be concerned about. Third and 9 for the Chargers. Man back to pass. Under pressure, brought down. Big play by the Chemics, Jordan Kohler. And the sack will send the Chargers back all the way into Midland territory at the 39-yard line. Bring up fourth and 16.
That was a double. There was great coverage downfield. And here comes the pressure up the middle. Now, number 20 gets in there, makes a great play.
Man to punt for Dow. Chance Freed back deep for the Chemics. Oh, and off the side of his foot.
And Mann's kick goes out of bounds. Midland High will take over.
Not a good kick by Mann.
And again, Midland has great field position.
8:23 to go in the second quarter. Difference in the game, a missed extra point by the Chemics. 7-6, Dow on top.
Tickets are $1
Midland will take over at their own 39-yard line.
$5 for an arm's length and $10 for a legs
line. Offensive line for the Chemics, the center, number 60, Zach.
Landis
at left guard, Cam White, 64 right guard, Spencer Parsh, the left tackle, RJ Allen
March 24th, hope to see you all there for
the
a fun
right
evening.
Tackle.
Drawing will be during halftime.
Warren in the backfield for Midland, this time receivers split out wide to the right and the left. Warren will take it. Trying to find some room to run, not much doing.
Not much there.
Stevenson in on the stop for Dow. Changed up a little bit to beach back out.
Stevenson and
Andron. Not in the lineup at the moment. Carter Gross to the left. Get good to the right. Metner fires, got his man as get good. And that's thrown down by Stevenson and Michael Bertrall. The 3 yards shy of the first down. Midland will need to get to the 49, move the chains. Just over 7 minutes to go in the second quarter. It's been a dandy so far in a packed Midland Stadium. Stadium is ringed on both ends by fans. Midland will call the first timeout of the half. Folks, you're watching this Midland High, Dow High football game on MCTV 189 on Charter Communications. You can also find this game on Channel 99 through AT&T's UVerse. The game will be cablecast on the following dates of time. Dates and times, it's Friday, October 21st at 11 p.m. Then Saturday, October 22nd, and Sunday, October 23rd at 8 a.m. and 8 p.m. And after this weekend, the game will be shown on MPS-TV 190. Check out the Sunday Midland Daily News and the Midland Public Schools website at www.midlandps.org for dates and times. The game will also be shown on the school's YouTube channel. Again, all the tremendous volunteers we have bringing you this game and many other sporting events. MCTV did the Midland Dow volleyball game earlier this week.
Big play right here, Dave. Third and three.
Counter to Money. He's got room to run. He gets the first down. Drives ahead. Good strong run by Mark Money. Fake the handoff for Warren. A little counter to Money, and he moves the chains.
That's exactly the play that scored the touchdown. He got him the first down, but more important than that, it's going to be able to see right there. There's a little delay.
Great job blocking by the right side of that Chemics
line. Excellent job of blocking.
Tight end Ben Worley out there sealing that hole, keeping it open, and Midland into Dow territory once again.
See, this is able to, you're going to be able to flip that field again. Even if you don't get a first down here, Dow's going to have that long yardage play.
Money on the carry. going to get about three. He's brought down by Stevenson, Brennan Doyle.
Doyle
was just a sophomore,
Stevenson.
Number 34.
This is really the first time we've seen Money all year running the football. And you can see what a difference maker he is. He looks an awful lot like his father and uncles. I mean, just take the football and get out of my way.
Been banged up.
Yeah.
Didn't play our previous telecast. Fake to Money. Mettner picks his way ahead, and he's going to come close to the first. And it is going to be a Chemic first down. Fake the handoff to Money. Mettner, the junior, keeps, and Midland gets just beyond the 35-yard line. Good job mixing things up.
Well, again, if you take a look as we see this, Dow's defense is now playing up again. And you're able to run the football when a team plays up. You got to play below the pads.
So now we got that full house backfield. A couple of Walkers and a Money. Walker is going to take it. Drive ahead for about three or four. Hauled down by several Chargers.
Gain of three.
Connor Moe. Stevenson in on the tackle. Clock moves. Five to go here in the second quarter. Again, that full house backfield. Vincent Walker, number 10, is brother Vaughn Walker, 34. Back to pass is Mettner. Fires downfield deep, and it is incomplete. Nice job defensively.
Pass is incomplete.
Broken
play
up by Michael Bricault. Trying to go for the big play to Trey Childrey, big sophomore. Great job by Bricault there in the secondary.
This is the first time we've seen Trey also. He's been hurt all year, along with Money and the young Walker. So you've got three key players that are back in your lineup. That makes a big difference.
Personal foul against Dow High.
Nope.
Personal foul against Midland High.
So hold against Midland. Personal foul against Dow. This penalty's offset. We'll replay second down. Yeah, Coach Mettner at that luncheon this week just mentioned how he had the injury bug more than he's seen in recent years. But didn't really make excuses. It's just next man up. Guys come to play.
Exactly.
And unfortunately, the Sam Vogel, the senior running back, out with an injury tonight, which was feel bad for Sam. Outstanding player. Pitch left to Money. Gonna cut it back to the right. Still on his feet, fumbles it. He loses it. There's a flag. Money tried to make an extra play and it was knocked loose. We'll see what the flag is. Is discussing. It's going to be a hold in Midland. Dow will decline it. And there's the big turnover. So the play was run left. Stevenson did a great job. You can see he wasn't going to go anywhere, so he took it to the right. Tried to break one tackle, but unable to do it. And Kate Skinner strips the ball on the turf. Dow takes over at 31-yard line. Four and a half to go here in the second quarter.
Yeah, see, this is great field position for Dow. I mean, most people, their good field position is get it on your side of the 50. Theirs is, if we get it outside the 20, it's great field position.
That's right. It's a quick strike offense. That's a huge play. Midland moving the ball.
Yes.
Running the clock. And now Dow late in the half. Try to strike. Man, back pass going deep again, and this time it is broken up. Great coverage by Vondre Warren of the Chemics. Brendan Cook was the intended receiver. And trying to hit another big play, but Warren all over the coverage.
Terrific coverage by Warren. Again, he is at a height disadvantage on Cook and just went right up and took the ball out of the hands.
Second and 10 for the Chargers. Stredney, Fabiano split wide to the right. Cook wide to the left. Man's going to keep it. Quarterback draw. Under pressure, and he just brought down. Again, it's Walker. It's a late flag.
Flag on the play.
Holding against Dow.
Holding against Dow.
So Walker again with the big play for Midland.
Now, do you decline this? Or do you take the 10 yards?
Third and 10, usually take the yardage.
Usually you do, but.
Wait, Dow's been able to hit it big. Yeah. I think you take the yardage here.
I take it.
Bring up second and 20. Makes a second instead of third, but usually figure play is to be hard to get more than 10 yards on the play.
Second and 21.
It's always a tough call.
It's a tough call against a team that can get 20 yards easily and may not be able to get 10 yards. You know, it's a tough call. Personally, I would have declined.
Soraki, a sophomore in the backfield, he'll go in motion left. Man, it's a little screen pass. Oh, man, what a defensive play. Warren again with a major stick. Cook caught it on the screen, and Warren read it and just put his face mask right on the floor of Dow.
Two terrific plays by Vondre Warren. Just terrific plays. Nobody took Vondre Warren out, and that's a mistake on Dow's
part. Warren on the pass. Brings up third down.
So third and 20. Man, back pass. There's got to be a hold. Man's open, and he's going to be a little bit short.
Man's pass is complete.
He missed a major hold out there. He took Walker's jersey right off his shoulder pad. And that was a big miss because it's going to be fourth and a yard and a half with 2:50 to go in the half. Dow looks like they're going to go for it.
They're going to go for it. This could, you know.
So they just try to get Midland off sides.
Flag on the play.
And so Dow, somebody.
Midland was off sides. Oh my goodness.
Midland High.
Nope. Was he lined up off sides?
He lined up off sides.
First down for Dow High on the penalty.
Who's the change for Dow?
Ball is at the 44-yard line of Dow High.
You know, This is a crucial play right here, because a crucial series. It's 2:37 to go, and really the momentum of this game has, even though Dow is ahead, Midland's defense is providing momentum for their offense. And their offense has shown it can move the ball.
Man, back to pass. There's a flag on the play. Cook has got it. He's going to race, still on his feet. Inside the 10, there's a flag on the play, though. I think this one may be coming back.
Flag on the play.
So the big play from Mann to Coop, were you talking about? And they're going to bring it back. It's a hold on the Chargers.
Holding against Dow High brings the play back.
Wow. 2:17 to go. A lot of action here in this
A lot of
possession.
Action. And as I said, right now, momentum is on the side of the Chemics. And so you've got to say to yourself, okay, if you're Dow, you got to turn the momentum on the other way. That was almost the play that did it.
Yeah.
During halftime, the
man's just got a lot of poise back there in the pocket. And
at that time, they ask you if your pocket change,
a nice
ready to place the buckets. We'll have only 1 minute to collect as much as possible.
He throws a very catchable ball. It's not heavy. It's not light. It's just smooth. It has a lot of tone on it.
2 minutes in the half. And back to pass, quarterback draw. He's gonna keep it for blockers. Good job by Midland. The ball comes loose.
They're gonna call him down.
Money in on the stop for Midland, among others.
Money on the initial hit.
Bring up second and 21 for Dow with a minute and a half to go. The clock's running.
Second and 21.
Man, back to pass. He's going deep and just overthrown. Pretty good coverage there by the Chemics. Zach Servinsky on the coverage. Man would have had to put that
third and 21
perfectly.
I've been very impressed with the secondary coverage in this first half by Midland High against the Dow receivers. They had the one breakdown there, which was a big run that was called back by the penalty. But other than that, most of them have been, even the touchdown was well covered. It was just a perfect pass.
Third and 21, 1:09 to go in the half. You never feel Dow's out of range of making a first. Intercepted by Midland. Warren races down the right sideline. Still on his feet and inside the five. There is a flag on the play. We'll see what it is. The ball was tipped, and Vondre Warren, who's made some huge defensive plays, makes another as he scoots down the right sideline. It's going to be hold on down. That'll be decline. And what a turn of events. Inside a minute to go. Let's take another look at it. Fired a little bit high off the hands of Cook. And Chase Perry with a hit, and then Warren races down the right sideline. Give man credit, not giving up on the play. And so Midland with the ball resting on the Dow 5 yard line. Dow up 7-6 here late in the first half. It's a timeout by the Chargers.
It was a good timeout. Slow things down a little bit.
Yeah, that's a great point. It's not just
slow things down.
Your team might be a little rattled, and you might say, what just happened? Kind of say, hey, let's just go play our game. And so Midland with two timeouts remaining, ball on the five.
Terrific play by Vondre Warren here.
Ball just a little bit high. Cook unable to catch it, and Warren, good reaction to be able to catch it. And then he just sprinted down the right side.
And he does know where the end zone is. The thing is, we've now had three holding penalties on the right side of Dow High. The inability to handle the rush out there.
Yeah, you're right.
And one that should have been called and wasn't.
Yeah, that led to the first down in the first place. So here we go. Full house backfield. Money, the ball carrier, trying to get around the left side. Gets down, dives, and he is in for the touchdown. Martin Money would not be denied. What a run by Money. Did not think he was going to get there. And he dove for the pylon and just caught it with the football. Dow had him contained. Money around the left side, breaks one tackle, smells the end zone, dives, and holds the ball out with his right hand across the plane.
What do you think? Is Money a football player?
He is a football player. Is that a surprise, though?
No, it's not a surprise. And this has been the factor that they've missed all year long. Somebody else to take the pressure off of Vondre Warren and allow Vondre Warren to do what he does best.
So Midland will call timeout, their second of the half. And you'd only call a timeout here if you plan on going for two.
They probably plan on going for two, but to be honest with you, you don't chase points.
Yeah,
I mean, you have an extra, you have an, an excellent extra point kicker. It's too early to chase.
One of those discussions you have, I'm with you. I say you don't chase them. Fourth quarter, you start thinking about it. But, you know, not, it all depends how it works out. But the certainly looks like they intend to go for two. It's almost like maybe they just feel like it got the momentum. And, defense comes out, it will be Warren and Money in the backfield.
It wouldn't surprise me to see that little crossbuck play that they ran earlier.
Back to pass, he's looking for Walker, and he's got it! There's a flag on the play. Great catch by Walker. See what they're going to call. I don't know if they're going to call a push-off. Or what? It's going to be a hold against Dow. And it's good. Hold on Dow. Great catch by Walker. So much for not chasing the points. That pays off. And it's 14-7 Midland. Nice thrown ball by Mettner. Not bad coverage, but you go to the big receiver. Look at Walker. One-handed.
One-hand catch.
Gets his foot in bounds. Beautifully done. Things change in a hurry here at the stadium. Dow was marching down the field, had a big play called back, and you're thinking, well, they could make that end up getting a touchdown lead at the half and momentum. Instead, Midland turns the tables, converting the interception by Warren into the money touchdown. I don't think this half's over yet, Coach.
This half's not over. It's 51 seconds. There'll be a little pop-up, just like they had before.
Remember, there was the penalty was assessed on the kickoff, so Midland will kick from
now,
the 50-yard line.
Now, you know where the ball's going because Walker and Landis and
the other
are
players
on the other corner out there. So you know the ball's going that way. So you got to be able to block those two guys.
Deeper, Cooper fielded at the two. And he's hauled down.
Coach, the ball carrier.
Walker, of course,
Vince
in
Walker
on the stop, as is Aaron Reardon.
You're watching this game on MCTV,
well, you, what you said about
189 on Charter Communications.
Big players,
also
playing big.
Big players play big.
How about Walker tonight?
Walker,
tonight,
Andre Warren,
Sunday, Warren,
and Martin Money.
After this weekend, the game will be
so
on
45 seconds to go. Dow has two timeouts. I don't really look at them sitting on this ball, do you?
No, I don't.
You know, if they try to get something big, it can turn the momentum tables in a hurry. We know that. Four receivers out to the right, one to the left. Man, here's Walker. Unloads it. And incomplete. Great job by Mann to get the ball away, but Walker again disrupts
Vince
the play.
Walker bothering the passer on the
that
play.
Was a great play by Walker, but that was a really good play by Mann because he got he almost completed the pass. Second and 10, 40 seconds to go. Walker been all over the place. And quarterback draw. And not much doing. Walker and Jordan Kohler in on the stop. Bring third and long. With
I'm going to tell you, Midland's defense is fired up, and they are defeating the offensive blocks of Dow's line. And Midland's defense has been absolutely spectacular this half. They've made one mistake and it cost them a touchdown. And actually it wasn't a mistake, it was just
a great play. Yeah, true.
But Midland, you can just see the momentum of this game has changed well from about the middle of the quarter, even before the interception, where Midland was making great plays on defense.
Dow calls timeout here. Talk things over, Coach Jason Watkins, who's just done a phenomenal job as the Dow High coach. Decide what to do here on 3rd and 7.
3rd and 8 as play resumes.
Stevenson, long setback. Receivers out to the right and left. Downfield, the ball is tipped again by Walker. Oh my goodness.
Deflected pass by Vince.
He is
Walker.
Wreaking havoc. Wow. Fourth down. Now we'll punt. Middle will actually get the ball in decent field position, most likely, with punt with 20 seconds to go. Walker has also been a big factor on special teams throughout his career. He's blocked several kicks.
Man, back to punt.
See if he takes a stab at this one. Better punt by Man. Midland just get out of the way, and they do. And the clock will go down to 8 seconds. I suspect Midland will take a knee here. I mean, you got the momentum, you got the lead. I think if you told Coach Mettner he'd be up 14-7 at half, he'd have taken that in a heartbeat.
Absolutely.
Packed house here at Midland Community Stadium. By the concession end to the left, they're about three deep, ringing that side of the field. Hand it to Warren. Warren breaks loose. He's still on his feet down the left side. And he's finally brought down at the 20 on the last play of the half. So they just decided to see if he could break up off a big one. It was a big play, but time has expired in the half.
They're asking to put time on the clock.
Oh, wow, they are. Band. Oh, no. The time ran out. Yeah, that's okay. It's hard to see what the official was indicating there, but the raucous Midland crowd cheering their team on as both teams head into the locker rooms.
As the buckets pass by,
been a tremendous first half here.
Miracle
back and forth.
Muscular Dystrophy Association.
Big plays on both sides. And two tremendous coaches here today will go into the locker rooms trying to see what tweaks to make for the second half. Jason Watkins in his 8th season for Dow. 57-23, his record. He knows how to win a ball game. As does Coach Mettner in his 9th season, his record 72-24. And so, folks, we're going to send it on down to the field for today's halftime show. The Dow High Marching Band taking the field. They will be joined soon by the Midland Marching Band. Enjoy halftime, folks. We'll see you in the second half.
We are the sound of Charger Spirit. The Charger Band is led by senior drum majors Annalise Wolford and Ben Price. Our junior drum majors are Wes Cummings and Grant Ostergar. The band is under the direction of Mr. Steve DeReese, Mrs. Nikki Brewski, and Mrs. Sharon DeReese. The drum line is coached by Mr. Roger Stevens and Mr. Chris Sabrin. Please watch now as the band continues a long-standing tradition by forming the Block D. Now get on your feet and show your Trojan spirit with the Dow High School fight song.
Ladies and gentlemen, under the direction of Mr. William Monroe, Mr. Chris O'Connell, and Mrs. Karen Welser, with percussion specialist Judith Peterson, it's the Midland High School Chemic Marching Band. This year's band features drum majors Zach Monica, Juliana Roller, Jordan Gonder, and Leanne Reel. Band, take the field. The Midland High Band will now do an encore performance of their Monster Show finale with horn soloist Emily Hansen. We bring you music from The Phantom of the Opera. This is a tragic story of a man consumed by his internal demons and his struggles to find love. As we perform this great music, We would like you to remember that the scariest part about monsters is that we all have a darker side that lies within us. Sometimes we can control the beasts that dwell in our soul, and sometimes we are transformed into the very beings we fear most. Now, close your eyes and surrender to your darkest dreams with the music of the night. We would like to acknowledge our illusion consultant, Ms. Carrie Rostelin from Proximity Illusions, based in Auburn, Michigan, and Mr. Joe Cooley from Joe Cooley's Magic, based in Bay City, Michigan. Our student magic team was Leanne Riel, Danielle Herzberg, Joe Pastula, and Bailey Lichtenwald as the Phantom. In keeping with many years of tradition, the Dow High School Band will now perform with the Midland High Band for the rest of our halftime show. From 2015, it's Demi Lovato's mega hit, Confident. The bands would now like to welcome both of the Dow High and Midland High pom-pom squads. So well over 470 students will be on the field to perform a great tune from the movie Slumdog Millionaire. For our grand finale tonight, it's Jai Ho!
And welcome back to our second half after a tremendous halftime performance by both the Midland High and Dow High marching bands. And it's just such a great sight to see, Coach, each year where you get that field covered with band.
Over 400 members of both schools. Terrific.
And just
almost 500.
Putting on a tremendous show. And just love that. Do you think the bands, you know how there's a big rivalry in football, do you think they ever say, like, hey, our Tuba players are better than your Tuba players?
I think maybe at the band showcase.
Could be.
But not here.
Not here?
No.
No, we're in it together here. Come to the press box. And so we're going to take a look at some of the highlights from the first half, and there were many, that's for sure. We'll take a look. This is the
first play, touchdown by Money. You see just stiff arms. The outside linebacker, there's the defensive tackle, and Money, there's nobody else. Completely fooled. It was a great play. Completely fooled.
He was gone.
Everybody.
A healthy Martin Money makes a big difference.
He is a difference maker. And comes right back again. Bruce Mann throws a touchdown over 75 yards. And this right here is a big play. Fabiano gets going, gets his feet underneath him, and then runs away from the defense.
A little taunting action there at the end. Cost him on the kickoff. But Dow was up 7-6 at that point. And then here's the big play. One of the biggest
Very
plays
big
of the half.
Right,
it really
here.
Turned things around.
A little bit high, tipped up in the air. Vondre Warren is in the right spot and comes under control. And right here we see what he does best. He now knows where the end zone is. He's got a lot better speed than most of the guys there. Bruce Mann does a terrific job of holding him up. And as a result, the ball gets down inside the 5-yard line. And then this is Money right here doing exactly what Money does. He's gonna get to the perimeter. He's gonna be able to outrun the Dow defenders here in the corner. Dow does not tackle very well here.
Determination. Second touchdown of the day.
And then this
Money.
Is just a terrific catch by Walker in the corner.
For the 2-point
good
conversion.
Good throw. A very good throw.
And so with that, Chemics get back that missed extra point and go on top 14-7, which is where we're at now. Midland High. Coming to the game at 4-4, Dow at 7-1, Midland looking for the upset.
You know, okay, let's talk about upset. What causes an upset? You know, you think about this. I was thinking about this at halftime. Okay, what causes mistakes? Does the team make mistakes? The team that's favored, do they make the mistakes? In this case, yes, Dow has made lots of mistakes. Holding penalties, intercepted passes, poor tackling. Lots of mistakes. Momentum. Midland has now turned the game, and the momentum is on their favor. You can see it coming off the field. Dow's heads are down. Midland's encouraging their fans and hooping it up. But this is the most important thing. When a team comes into a game where they are heavily favored and they don't have the focus, and this in this case right here, Dow does not have the focus. Their whole first half, was, in my opinion, was very listless. They did not have that same giddy-up that we've been accustomed to in seeing Dow High football. So we'll see what happens. That's the beauty of football. There's two halves.
You
never
go.
Know what's going on, but I think Midland has played this out right. Both teams had four possessions in the first half. All right, we're going to take a look at these keys of the game and see where I'm at. 30 points seems like a long way away, but, you know, 30 points is not
there.
We're halfway there. Limiting Dow's possessions, that was great. They had four. Each team had four. And, again, that special team mojo of Midland has really done the job, especially the punt that pinned them down inside. Now, avoid turnovers. We see the big turnover, and that was that intercepted pass. Being physical, we have not seen that out of Dow. They have not been physical tonight. They've been what I call grabby tackle, cowboying. And their big play offense was present in a couple of them, One for a touchdown, and one got called back
because
of the inability to hold off Vincent Walker.
Yeah.
I mean, it comes right down to it. Vincent Walker is causing Dow High many problems. He is forcing Bruce Mann to move his feet, and that's exactly what you want to do when you have a quarterback who can
Ashley
throw.
Smith, please come to the press box. Ashley does not know where you are. She's here.
And Midland High will get the ball to start the second half.
Come on up.
As you mentioned, this is the 50th time these two teams have squared off, dating back to 1970. That was the year of the first city title game. Midland won that game 14-9. And fast forward ahead here, we're game number 50. It's the 47th city championship game between the two arch rivals. And we said, I mean, you've been at all but one. I kind of grew up through the whole rivalry, and it's unless you kind of live through it, it's hard to explain. It just has such a neat feel to it. It's just a special week that you get ready for. You look ahead the whole year to it, really, and this is the magical night that's here. Packed stadium, you know it's going to be packed on both sides, and both teams are fired up, ready to play, and we're going to have a tremendous second half.
Well, we have one side very excited, and we have the other side of the field going, what's happening? What is this? So it'll be interesting to see this second half.
Money will take the kickoff at his 14-yard line, finds a hole, and drives ahead. It'll be decent field position for Midland out to the 34-5-yard line. Boy, Money did not mess around on that. He takes it, finds a crease, and just bullets ahead until he's hauled down. So Midland will had found success on the ground, and really Mettner's done a nice job in the air on the short passing game and finding his spots.
Well, Mettner is 2 of 4 for 14 yards. Mann was 5 of 12 for 114 yards.
Warren, ball carrier, drive ahead. Nice job by Warren powering. Gonna pick up about 6 on the play. Brought down by Murray.
Warren, game 6, second and 4.
And so Warren, you know, coming into the game, you'll think of him as the scat back, the offensive threat. He made just as big an impact on defense. Some really nice plays, and that big interception that set up the second touchdown. Gonna go back to the two-back set with Money and Warren. Second and 3, it's gonna be Warren. And he's going to get the first, still driving ahead, running with authority is Warren. Warren running with purpose right now, Coach. Lance Johnson on the tackle.
That's a big first down right there. Now you're in a position to, even if you don't get the next first down, you're in a position to flip the field.
Ball to the 47-yard line. Clock is running. An offensive line doing a pretty good job here tonight. Get good. It's gonna be Warren, not much doing that time. Nice defensive stand by Alex Tomiko. Gonna pick up about a yard,
Alex
call
Tomiko
it.
On the stop. Gain of 1, second and 9.
Second and 9. Miko is a big fella, 6'1", 265 senior on that defensive line. Pitch right to Warren. He's got a little room, nice block out front, run out of bounds. He's gonna come close to the first down. Got a good block on the edge. And it will be
Connor Bowe, the stop.
About a yard short. Third and a yard. Take a look at this one. Just Walker on the block out here on the right. Held off the defender nicely.
defender never got in the play.
Oh, they're going to move the chains. So Midland does get enough for the first into Dow High territory on the Charger 43-yard line. Trips right this time in the formation. But it's Mettner fumbles, ball on the ground, and Dow recovers. Tried to pick it up instead of falling on it.
Fumble on the play, recovered by Dow High.
And big turnover for Midland. Man, moving the ball nicely to start the half.
And this is going to be Dow's best field position. Right off the bat, it was just a bad exchange. And then instead of falling on it, he tried to pick it up. And that's what the big fella does. He falls on it.
That was Murray on the recovery. So Dow in business at their own 49-yard line.
Now this is where Dow usually tries to strike fast. Right now I advise them to not strike fast, but to have a good series down here, get the first down.
Man, back to pass, looking to strike fast. Ball is deep and it's caught.
What do I know?
What do you know, coach?
they have done this all year long. I don't know why I'd even think of that.
Zervinsky had pretty good coverage, but
good coverage.
But
fell
Cook,
down.
Cook did a good job just getting good body position. Another great throw by Mann across the field from the far hash here.
See, the safety's gone over the middle, and now they're one-on-one out there, and you'll see Zervinsky's going to fall right back and be unable to handle it. Now Dow's in great position inside the 20, and this is where they score.
Kind of a back shoulder throw there. It was successful. First and 10 in the red zone. Man, back to pass, looking for the quick strike again. Wide open is Cook. And Man puts it on the money, a second touchdown pass. And
I told you, they score. They get inside the 20 and they score. Now, if they're inside the 5, they have to take a penalty. They haven't got enough room to score, but boy, I'll tell you, inside the 20, they are dangerous. And right there, perfect pass.
The little post pattern and on the money was Bruce Mann. Extra point is blocked. Set Walker. Let's see who got it, but.
I think we'll see it on replay on the touchdown. And here's the thing, there's the safety sitting in the middle, and he goes away.
Well, he had to right there.
Well, there's other guys there, but look at this right here. Wide open, perfect pass, great catch.
The extra point blocked, and so tables have turned a little bit as far as that goes. Midland missed their first one, went for two on their second touchdown. Time Dow's extra point was blocked by Midland.
Those extra points are gonna be big. Remember what I told you, you gotta score 30 points.
So,
all right, here comes the extra point. We wanna see where that comes from. Right in the middle, too low.
Yep, that was, it was blocked by Greg Landis. Little pooch kick and nice job by Chemics on the coverage.
Is received by Matthew Ware down at the 35-yard line.
Matthew Ware, the junior, receives it, goes down. So Midland will get decent field position again to start. Certainly move the ball in that first possession. You often talk about each team's first possession in the third quarter. Midland moved it, turns it over, Dow strikes immediately to tie the game. Or cut it to one. We'll see if now Midland can respond here. Had a lot of momentum, now you can sense it may be teetering just a little bit here. This time money will be the lone setback. Mettner back to pass. He's going deep for Walker and he has incomplete, underthrown a little bit. Walker had his hands on it and just couldn't hold on. Bricault on pretty coverage, but Walker had him beat. take another look at this.
Midland did a great job of picking up the stunt.
Nice pattern by good route there by Walker. He said just underthrown and he just dropped it, I think.
Unable to hold on to it.
Had his hands on it. He knew the defensive pressure was coming. Bring up second and 10. Pitch right to Warren. Strung out really well by Stevenson. And really good defensive play by Stevenson there.
It was a good defensive play, but not a good finish.
But he turned it back upfield, back into his teammates.
Did a good job, but you still have to finish your tackles.
Going to be a loss of a yard, third and 11 for Midland. So they go for the big strike on first down and kind of got out of their normal rhythm there.
This will be a good, yes, they got out of their normal rhythm. Now they're going to try to get one-on-one out here with Vondre Warren, even though they have three on the others. Here comes the screen to the backside. And Dow was ready for that.
That was Stevenson, read that play.
Yes, perfect.
Stevenson knew that was coming. It's like he was in the huddle. So a big loss.
Well, that's a favorite formation play for Midland High. Trips to the field and then bring back the screen. The surprise me was the screen didn't go to Vondre Warren.
Yeah.
He was used as a decoy.
And then we'll punt. Heavy pressure. Mighty got a piece of it.
A little
he
bit
did.
Of it.
He did get a piece of it. That was Bricault. Got a piece, so a really short kick by the Chemics. And momentum is definitely shifted here, Coach. The Midland had the turnover, quick strike by Dow, and then Midland has a three and out, and Dow has the ball in Midland territory.
In that formation, Midland went for the big play. And then they were unable to convert two other plays. And so now they had to punt. Now you give the ball to Dow inside the 50. And now that field, it's that field position that comes into play here.
Ball on the Chemic 42. Man, he's going deep again. Kukuk, and he's got him again. Man, on the money. Kuk having his way right now.
Kuk is an outstanding receiver. He has such soft hands. Perfect throw. And again, now the ball is on the 5-yard line. We'll see what we're talking about. The ability of Dow to get in the end zone here.
Dow just getting yardage in chunks. Just look, they just know they have something here. And man, with another big play, right, perfect pass. This time, man with a quarterback draw is gonna maybe gain a yard. Be second and goal from the 4.
One, first and goal inside the 5-yard line, the ball's at the 4. White.
That was just decided this half. They're just going to go big.
Well, what they're doing is they're isolating their receiver by clearing out everybody and putting him one-on-one and throwing the ball to the inside.
Stevenson, the ball carrier, is going to get to the outside, and he goes in for the touchdown. Spencer Stevenson with the touchdown run, and the Chargers regain the lead.
Now, here's the question. Do they chase the points?
Looks like they're gonna.
They're gonna chase them.
Dow going to go for 2 here. Got to overcome that block extra point from the last touchdown. Man, back to pass. Heavy pressure. There's got to be a hold there. There is. It's caught. Conversion is successful, but that's going to come back. It's a hold. But really great catch, which still gives him another crack at it.
And a lot more room to do it with. These holding penalties are absolutely killing Dow. And you got to give credit to Midland.
Yep.
Because.
Well, you hold for a reason. I mean, you're.
Exactly.
Usually you got beat, so you know.
Everybody holds. I mean, that's. But you got to let go. I mean, you got to keep your feet underneath you. What happens is you lose your feet. And when you lose your feet, then the pocket breaks down. You got to keep your feet going. You have to keep your shoulders square.
It's a little bit of confusion here. So we still go for two.
Ball is at the 13-yard line for the two-point conversion attempt.
Gonna be a little post here for Cook. And he fumbles the snap. And not gonna be able to get rid of it. And so that time chasing it didn't pay off. Look at touchdown.
Excellent run. The hole is jammed up. Good job of holding up. And here on the corner, Stevenson breaks a tackle. And now
it's all over there.
Yeah, it's in the end zone.
He wasn't gonna be denied at that point. And so Dow with two quick scores, 6:40 to go in the third quarter, regains the lead, 19-14. See if Midland goes back to their
run game.
The run game. They took a shot at the deep pass and they had it, actually.
They had it.
It was a good call, just weren't able to pull it off, and then that kind of disrupted the drive.
And the partially blocked punt gave Dow the field position that was necessary. Same
little pooch,
same
kick
pooch
again.
Kick.
Oh, this is trouble. Oh no, it's picked up by the Chemics. Boy, once it hit the turf, anything can happen.
Right.
Get good was able to pick it up, and Midland will have pretty good field position again.
Ball is brought to the 37-yard line.
Start at the 37-yard line. See that pooch hit the ground and fortunately bounced
right
to
the Dow.
That takes one of those backwards bounces or sideways. Anything could happen. Two tight ends for the Chemics. It's Warren running left. Oh, he got stuck.
Vondre Warren.
Defensive play by
Stevenson on the tackle. No gain on the play. Second and 10.
Answer it. Or no, excuse me. That was Alex D'Amico. No gain on the play for Midland.
Nice short pass right here. Throw it and let him run with it.
Pass. There's that quick pass. It's caught.
Excellent.
For about 5 yards. Good call, coach. It's Carter Grove, the sophomore.
More of the same. Dow's given him the short passes all night.
Grove had 5 catches on the year coming in, 23.4 yards per catch. Warren, their leading receiver, with 15, Get Good with 10 coming into the game. and also the leading rusher for the Chemics. Third and four. Midland's going to call timeout. They're running out of time.
See, this is a little bit of confusion. Now, these timeouts really hurt you late in the game. In a close game, 19-14, this is a very close game. And a confusion timeout hurts you at the end of the game when you need it the most.
It's definitely a big play here. You don't convert and you put the ball back in the hands of the Dow offense, which is two big strike scores. All three of their touchdowns really off of big plays. Coach Mettner talking it over with his son, the quarterback, and the rest of the team.
It's interesting, both quarterbacks are coaches' sons.
Oh yeah, right.
Man's father was the head coach at Western for many years, and of course, Cade is the son of Eric.
Empty backfield for Mettner. Back to pass. Fires. High caught by Getgood. He dropped the ball, but I'm sure he was down. They are going to call him down. Had to be forward progress. Mettner put a little mustard on that one.
That was a good pass and a very good reception.
Kind of into some traffic there. Put a little extra on it. Getgood with the nice hands. Hauls it in. Ball in Charger territory at the 49. Just under five to go in the third quarter. 2016 City Championship game here at Midland Community Stadium. Again, a packed house, a crisp fall night. Great night to watch some football. Money up the middle, drives ahead.
Martin Money, like a battering ram there.
Yeah. I like how he runs.
See, I
like deceptive speed and a lot of power.
I really like what Midland's doing right now. Short passes, hard straight ahead running. Stay away from the laterals.
Two walkers in the backfield now along with Money, and it's going to be Vince Walker spinning ahead, and I think he's going to get the first down. He does. So a little wrinkle. Familiar formation, different personnel. And Walker able to pick up the first down. Clock continues to run. Vince Walker has put his stamp firmly on this game. Mostly defensively, but he had the big two-point conversion in the first half on a reception. That time runs the ball. Vaughn Walker this time, and he is wrestled down.
Stevenson made a great play.
When you see a tackle like that, you just pretty much assume it's Stevenson, don't you?
Yes.
Gets the guy down and or gets him and throws him down. Second and 10 for Midland. Vaughn Walker comes out, Money in. Vince Walker now at the right tight end position. Mettner, the
two-man pattern.
He's under pressure. Throws deep downfield, and it is intercepted.
Pass is intercepted. Nick Siraki on the interception.
Nick Siraki, sophomore, with the interception. Midland goes deep again. Second turnover of the half.
It's quite an interception by Siraki.
Yeah, it is.
See, it's only two receivers going on. I mean, maximum protection. So you got eight guys in the defensive coverage.
There's only three guys rushing.
And now here you got a floating throw. And here comes the safety in the middle of the field And, you know, that's a good play by the safety.
Ball on the 10. See if they go big again. No, this time, oh man, another nice defensive play. By
Snyder
Hunter
made a
Snyder.
Nice play.
Gonna lose a yard. But Guerriere was the ball carrier. Two minutes to go in the third quarter. Second and long. Man, back to pass. He's going deep again. And oh, great defensive play that time. Zach Servinsky. Pass was intended for Fabiano, and Servinsky laid out and broke it up.
That was a good pass, but I got to tell you, that was a great defensive play by Servinsky.
Man has been on the money in his throws.
A little short, and the receiver had to come back for it.
There's a flag. Holding on Dow declined. That time I would agree on declining. It would only been half the distance, so. Third and 10. This is a big play. Midland defense, if they can stop them, we'll get the ball. Probably in Dow territory or good shape anyway. Dow trying to keep on moving, keep the Midland offense off the field. High snap again. Man fires, got his man again. Beautifully thrown ball. Kook is the play. Hauls it in. Straight now, this half, they don't have an answer for the man to Kook combination.
Especially in that little deep out. Man's thrown that perfectly every time.
It's such a hard pattern to cover, really. Because even if you cover it pretty well, if you throw a perfect ball, there's not much you can do about it. First and down, first and 10, Dow converts. Guerriere, and that's Walker on the tackle.
Guerriere, front of Vince Walker, gain of 2nd and 8.
2 yard pickup, be 2nd and 8. One difference this half is Midland has not gotten the same kind of pressure on man that they did in the first half.
No.
That's the adjustment that Dow made, I think, because man's had time to throw the deep ball. Stevenson, the ball carrier, drives ahead, runs over would-be tacklers and moves the chains.
Stevenson, the ball carrier.
That was a hard run.
Oh, my gosh.
That was a hard run.
I was thinking that's a...
I think Gary
to commit
take,
to making that tackle.
Take a lesson from watching Stevenson run.
Just north,
he
south.
He runs hard.
Oh, that was a broken play right there. He missed a handoff. And Walker and Landis in on the stop. Maybe the last play of the half, or the quarter, excuse me.
Walker and Vincent Walker on the stop.
Yeah, the Chargers will be content to let the clock wind down here at the end of the third quarter. A very successful quarter for Dow. Had 2 scores. Meanwhile, Midland had 2 turnovers. That results in Dow being up 19-14. So this coverage of this football game is being produced by MCTV volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come to the next orientation studio training class on the second Saturday in November. That's the 12th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Cost is just $45, which includes annual access user fee. Call 837-3474. Come down to the MCTV studio in the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. You can learn more about MCTV at www.cityofmidlandmi.gov/MCTV or follow MCTV on Facebook. It's fun to volunteer at MCTV. Just ask Frank tonight. Enjoying this game with a lot of the new technology we've been able to do and these tremendous replays that we're able to bring you. And so we are about to get underway here in the fourth quarter. Dow is second and 13. And back to pass, looking deep again under big pressure from Walker. He eludes him, fires downfield, and it is incomplete. Caught, but out of bounds. That time, Midland did get the pressure on man. He had to run hard to his left, throw across his body, and really a great pass and catch, but had to throw it a little later than he wanted, and result is the receiver's out of bounds.
The pressure from Walker.
It's double teamed.
Double teamed.
Got held.
Again, your feet don't move. When your feet don't move, you're in trouble. And then you get a block in the back. That was even more crucial.
Third and 13. Walker double teamed this time. Fired by man, incomplete. Receiver unable to hold on to that one. Intended for Stredney, and Dow will punt.
That ball had a little zip on it.
It sure did. Much needed stop for the Chemic defense. The first quarter, that third quarter, Midland's offense moved, but two turnovers, and Dow had two scores, so Midland defense really needed to stand there. Freed to receive. Under pressure again from Walker, and it will go out of bounds in Chemic territory. I don't know if he got a piece of it, but he certainly affected the kick.
He just runs right around. He runs right around the defender, or the blocker.
He just wreaks havoc.
Listen, he's an impact player. It's just, you have to account for him. And right now, Dow is not accounting for him. See, now right here, he's out here. Now watch.
Oh, he made a move on him.
You just got to stay back and.
Well, you know what? I think man knew if he just punted it like he normally does, it was going to get blocked. So he kind of tried to elevate it a little more. Midland takes over at the Dow 48. Warren found a little hole. He's gonna pick up some yardage. Bovee on the tackle. Picks up about five on the play. And then going back to that bread and butter, Warren with a lot of carries in the first half. The big difference between these two is Dow can have a big strike, big play offense. Not as much chance of that on Midland, although Money did have that long run. Warren left tackle again, and this time not much doing. Murray, Stevenson, Johnson on the stop. Bring up third and four for Midland. Big play here for the Chemics. Certainly don't want to give the ball right back to Dow.
You're going to look for a short. Well, here, Vondre Warren is out. Money is in. Watch for a pitch for Money. I mean, Money is in for a reason.
Well, the one thing Money can do is if he gets initial contact, he's powerful. Oh, Midland's got to call another timeout. It's their second of the half already. Again, it's on a big play, but, you know, when you come down the stretch here in the fourth, they just have one timeout.
As a coach, you hate confusion timeouts.
But in the circumstance, you got to call that.
You can't
have a third and nine instead of a third and four.
Thank you to all who gave. MHS DECA collected $260, and Dow High DECA
mentioned
collected $236.
Dow High has clinched a playoff spot, and
well,
see what happens after
this. If Dow
this.
Wins this game, they will probably host Traverse City West here next Friday night. If Dow loses this game, they most probably will travel to Traverse City West and probably play on Saturday.
So here we go.
Third and four.
Full house backfield. Midland still looks a little confused. Money off tackle. Powers ahead. He's going to be a little short, I believe.
About a yard short.
Oh, he got a great spot. Oh, my.
Oh, my goodness.
The official on this side is given the first down. The official on the other side had it short. That was a very favorable spot.
First down, Midland High.
Stevenson knows it. And, Coach Watkins is arguing it. I don't really blame him. I think they went with this official's call because it was on this side of the field. Nevertheless, first and 10, Chemics, just under 10 minutes to go. Money, left tackle again, drives ahead, and he loses the ball. Money took a big hit.
I think Midland has it.
Second time he's put it on the turf. Midland does recover. Wow, what a break for the Chemics.
Fumble is recovered by Midland High.
Greg Landis, Johnny on the spot, saves the day. Good, strong, powerful
and
run by
see,
Money. But
this is in Dow's hands, and they don't fall on the ball.
Good stick there.
See what I mean? They can't find it. Three of them.
Bo V with a really nice hit. This time Dow High calls the timeout. Their first of the half. Midland first down at the Dow 27, moving the ball. They have moved the ball effectively this half, Coach, but have turned it over twice. Just narrowly averted a turnover there.
Northwood versus Michigan Tech. Come down to Hans Stadium. Northwood versus Michigan Tech.
Looking for more of the same, just chewing up yardage on the ground. Can you stick to the ground game here, Coach?
I wouldn't go anywhere else. I mean, Dow has shown that it is willing to give up 5 yards every time.
Money's running with authority here.
First tap.
Warren's done a good job too, but they kind of mix it up. Money running the ball as well. Full house backfield, the two walkers ahead of Money. It's handoff to the left side again. Powering ahead again. Dow trying to strip it. He's going to gain another big chunk to bring second and one.
Dow. Midland, I gotta say, is putting a lot of people at the point of attack. Not only their offensive line is doing a great job off the ball, but the two up backs are running right through the hole.
Well, left side, left tackle Spencer Parson, left guard Greg Landis. They've been working that left side quite a bit. Again, left side is Money. Got the first down, driving ahead inside the 10. Martin Money.
First down,
come to
now,
play.
Now, you watch. Dow will jam up the hole, and Money reacts and steps to the outside. Dow does a good job of jamming the hole up.
Run left side, bringing both those up backs.
You can see it right there. Good, he sees seal block. Right there, makes cut a nice cut. Right. And it's a little bit of a jump cut. And now we'll see what happens. Again,
Money
same
again
play
on the left side. Plows ahead for a couple. Kevin Murray on the stop for the Chargers. Second and goal from the 7. 8:14, the clock is running. Dow on top, 19-14. Midland trying to change it.
I wouldn't
change that right here.
And I wouldn't change any play. I'd stay right in that because Dow has not proven they can stop it.
They've run the same play about 4 times. This time Money checks out and Warren will be the running back. It is the same play. This time Warren gets about to the 4-yard line.
Advances the ball to the 4-yard line. Brings up
Money's going to come back in.
They're going to run that ball right over Landis.
Third and goal from the 4. You do it again. Run the play about 5 times in a row. Midland fans on their feet. Crowd, the stadium is rocking. The Dow High faithful cheering on their defense. The Midland High cheering on their offense. Money again, same play. Tries to get to the outside, strung out nicely. That was a great defensive play. Zeitler, Ben Zeitler, the junior, with a tremendous play.
Fourth and goal.
Fourth and goal. You lost yardage that time. Ball on the 5.
Well, I would say here comes Vincent Walker on a little fake. Fake the run, pop the pass. Find Vincent Walker.
It's going to be the power
He's
backfield.
In the backfield. So no, it's not going to.
He does fake it. He's trying to get to Walker. He can't get released. Mettner surveying the field, finds his man. Touchdown! It's the other Walker. What a play by Mettner. They tried to go to Walker like you called. He got held up at the line of scrimmage.
They did a great job of holding him up, and Cade Mettner made the play. Scrambled around, got free.
You can see on the replay here, number 10. Vince Walker is going to try to release just like you called. It's the exact play, but he got bumped by his own guy, held up.
Held up.
So wisely, Mettner didn't throw it where it wasn't there. Surveys the field, runs left. Finds Vaughn Walker. And he takes it in. Oh, what a play. Midland up by 1 now is going to go for 2 to try to make it a 3-point game. Try to make it a where a field goal would only tie it. This is a good spot for a 2-point conversion here with 6:20 to go, and Midland calls their final timeout of the half. Midland's had to use all 3 timeouts, more for confusion than strategy. Although honestly, the timeouts have paid off.
Timeouts have paid off. Absolutely they have.
See Coach Kevin Lawson talking to Mettner, giving his suggestion on the play. Coach Lawson, a Northwood grad. Looking for a similar type thing to go back to the that dive off the left side.
To me, you hadn't stopped that play. I'd be in the triangle.
With Money?
With Money and say, okay, here we come. What are you going to do about it? You have the lead. So, you know, they've got to score.
Oh, I was impressed with Mettner on that play. You know, you called the play. He just wasn't there. And instead of forcing something, he made something out of nothing.
Made something happen.
So, Mettner back to pass. Fires, got it! Get good for the 2-point conversion. And the Chemics go up by 3. What a play call. Just didn't quite see that. They spread it out for the two-point conversion. Mettner finds Getgood for the conversion, and Midland goes up by a field goal. 6:21 to go. This is shaping up to be a classic here at Midland Community Stadium. Dow High heavily favored coming into this game at 7-1. And but like you say, you throw the records out for a game like this. Midland had a game plan and stuck with it. And both teams have made some big plays. It's been back and forth. It's been a dogfight. Midland throws the last punch. Dow is not done here. You know that.
You know, the thing that's interesting here is that Midland has had outstanding field position. Dow's inability to punt the ball because of Vincent Walker. That play right there, they were so concerned about Vincent Walker that they let everybody else go.
Yeah, it looked like they knew that was the play too. Archibald's kickoff. Fielded at the 12 on the run by Cook. Still on his feet. Going to take it out to the 36. Good return by Cook. And Dow has got pretty decent field position to start and try to respond to the Midland drive. 6:15 to go here at the stadium. Again, a packed house here. Probably 10,000 football fans seeing a classic. High school football at its finest right here. Bruce Mann, the senior quarterback. Phenomenal year, phenomenal game. Can he lead his team back? Back to pass, he's under pressure. Surveys the field, looking down, goes deep, and really throws it away. Threw it safe. Well, great coverage by the Midland secondary on that one. He's looking for Cook, but he was double covered.
Second and 10.
Man flushed out of the pocket.
Again by Walker.
You almost have to double team him, don't you?
Well, Dow wants to go vertical down the field. And really, you know, you got to just take your time. And he's good enough. The guys are open enough. Those little out patterns that he's completed on every third down.
Second and 10, 6:06 remaining. Man, back to pass. It's quarterback draw. He's got room to run. He's got the first down into Midland territory and more. Driving ahead. Man takes it all the way to the 38-yard line.
So Midland played the three-man line. So they both went to the outside. Of course, they're playing coverage. Man sees it, keeps the ball, runs down the field, makes a terrific gain.
Man, great competitor.
Now, this is where Dow is at its toughest. They get inside your 40-yard line.
Cook is... got single coverage out there with Warren, wide to the left. They found success throwing that post to him. Little Statue of Liberty type play to Bovee. And a new wrinkle for Dow. They haven't run that play all game long, and it's gonna move the chains. Landis and Sasicki on the tackle, but no, it'll be
short by about a half a yard, maybe.
No, they're moving.
Oh, they're moving the chains.
First down down.
First down. So Dow, after Midland's dramatic touchdown, arching right back down the field. 5:12 to go. Who's gonna make a play? Ball on the 29. Man's gonna keep it around the left end. Driving ahead, Walker on the tackle, and Reed. Good job to pick up four. The initial hole wasn't there, and he popped it out left and then spun around for extra yardage.
Man's a hard runner. Big. He's big too. You're not. You stand next to him and you say, "Okay, that's a big quarterback." I remember standing next to him when he was a sophomore, and I said, "That is a big sophomore quarterback." And I mean, he's physically big.
And now he's a big senior quarterback trying to will his team to victory. Trips left. Spencer Stevenson in the backfield. Man, back to pass. Looking deep into the end zone. A lot of contact, but it was really good coverage. The Dow receiver really ran over the Midland receiver. It's good no call. Servinsky on the coverage. And that was Stredney was the intended receiver, 6'3", 170 senior. Third and six, 4:15 remaining. Midland on top, 22-19. Dow trying to answer. Been back and forth contest today. Midland took early, scored the first touchdown. Dow took the lead. Midland came back, took the lead. Dow took the lead, and now Midland has it. Back and forth we go. Man, back to pass. He's got plenty of time. Fires, and it's incomplete. They're going to throw a late flag. Oh, I don't know about that one. Ball sailed over his head. They're going to call interference on Midland. What a huge call.
There's nothing in high school about an uncatchable pass. But it just seems
the ball was already
there.
The
ball was already passed.
Didn't you think so?
I did. We're going to see right here on the replay. Right. Oh, there is. That's contact.
Yep,
that's a good call.
So now Dow has it on the Midland 13-yard line. 4:09 to go in the game. There's an official's timeout here. Three-point Chemic lead.
It was a very good call. The reason the ball went over his head is because he was hit before the play.
Fabiano in motion left. Man, quarterback draw. Big play, he's got room to run. Man drives ahead, and he's gonna be just short. Oh, he was determined on that one. Some late joy.
Oh, wow. Now he's gonna be a sportsmanlike on Dow.
Midland sure thinks so.
Flag on the play.
They're gonna talk it over. What a run by man. Quarterback draws their most effective running play.
Here comes Spencer Stevenson. He makes a great block.
Man drives ahead, power run down right at the 1 yard line. Officials are trying to weed through it. Then man's kind of jawing at the Midland player there. They're waving off the flag. Wow.
Flag is disregarded. Waved off.
Looking at the replay, I can see why they waved it off.
Maybe they just decided they didn't want to affect the outcome here. Which Mettner wants an explanation.
This is interesting officiating crew. I have had this crew at almost every Dow Midland football game from when I was coaching.
Oh, wow. So 3:58 remaining. Dow has the ball, first and goal from the 1 yard line. We're in the fourth quarter. Dow looking to punch it in. Will we see Stevenson here?
Absolutely.
He is the lone setback. Man under center. Could be a quarterback sneak. It is a sneak. And he is going to be short. he got held up, and then Mann kept fighting to try to get over. He's so close.
Shy of the goal line. Second down and goal. Ball's inside the 1 yard line.
.324 to go. Clock is running. Ball, you can see, resting on the 1 yard line. Talk about really, Coach, him getting stopped there probably helps Dow, actually.
Absolutely. Slow the game down.
It just takes up more
personally
clock.
Right now, I'd let him score.
Yeah.
You know they're going to score. Let them score and get the ball back.
Stevenson waltzes into the end zone, untouched, big hole. They're focused on man, and Dow will regain the lead. They go up by three. Certainly they'll go for one here.
It's a good run by Stevenson, and good blocking
by Dow. It's
great
blocking.
Great right there, 53, did a great job.
That's a Ryan Mary, 6'4", 225. Great seal block. Extra point. There's a flag on the play. Midland is offsides.
Again, Greg Landis in the mix of that.
Midland offsides. They'll get another crack at this one. Ashton Brooks, the kicker.
To me, if there's any weak spot in the Dow system, it's their special teams. I mean, right here, you can see it. You know, I watched all year long the number of times teams almost got there, and they shouldn't have even been close. And we see tonight the two block kicks are almost blocked.
Big extra point. This one is going to go up and good. Ashton Brooks makes it a 4-point game. That was big.
Okay, what makes that big is that Archibald is a danger from
right
at 40 yards.
Exactly.
So that's what makes that a big first.
It takes him
point
out of the picture.
Exactly.
Midland
now
needs a
Midland
touchdown.
Midland needs
a
score. 3 minutes. Plenty of time.
No timeouts, remember. Midland's used them all.
And remember what we said. Those confusion timeouts will cost you at the end of the game.
So impressive drive by Dow. Aided by that pass interference call, but still. Give them credit. After Midland takes the lead on a great drive, Dow just marches right back downfield between the arm and legs of Bruce Mann. And then Spencer Stevenson, the tremendous linebacker but power runner, plunges into the end zone to give Dow that 4-point lead. Dow High trying to extend their winning streak in this rivalry, trying to make it four straight for the first time in their history, trying to make it three straight city titles for the second time. Midland obviously trying to put an end to that streak. Now we'll kick from the 40. Be looking for a pooch kick here. They're probably not going to risk money or Warren getting a big return.
I'm all for a low line drive.
Here is the pooch kick. Fielded at the 29, trying to get around to the edge. He got a block, still on his feet. Not bad field position for the Chemics. It's Carter Grove on the return. Thought he might try to get all the way across the field, but.
Again, great field position for Midland.
2:49 to go in the contest. Chemics need to march 60 yards to get a victory. There won't be a field goal. Midland down by four. It's 26-22. Dow on top. Mettner back to pass. Fires, and it's incomplete. Try to hit money.
Pass is incomplete.
Fired it a little behind
him.
Yeah,
a little pistol on it.
Second and 10.
Little vinegar.
Second and 10. Do you have time to run it much here, Coach? I don't
know. You have a lot of time. You see, the rule says 10 yards, 10 seconds. So you had 60 yards. So you can do that in a minute if you concentrate on that. But if you don't, so you can run plays. You've got plenty of time.
Mettner back to pass. Got a man as Warren over the middle, first down. Midland moves the chains. Nice play call there. Warren slipped out of the backfield. And good short pass into Dow territory. Down to the 47-yard line. Chemic fans in front of us all on their feet. Mettner back to pass. Fires a little bit short. Good coverage by the Chargers. Bercault on the coverage. Bring up a second and 10.
Notice Bruce Mann is now the safety in the middle of the field. You have some receivers out there playing defense.
Well, I put one of your best athletes out there. Trying to prevent Midland hitting home run here. Trips left.
Watch out for Walker.
Mettner back to pass. Fires a little screen pass to Warren. Minimal gain. It's going to be third and about six. Clock runs 2:15 to go. Midland needs to hurry here. Third and six. Down to the 2 minute mark. Mettner back to pass. Got a little time. Fires downfield. Overthrows Murray under heavy pressure on Mettner. It's had unloaded. It'll bring up fourth and six. The game on the line here. The Dow High fans. Waving to their team, waving to their fans that make some noise.
You have weapons. You have Vondre Warren. You have money. You have Walker. Go to those weapons.
1:49 remaining.
And in Dow's case, stop those weapons.
Midland needs to get 6 yards to keep their season alive.
Penalty.
They're back to pass.
Flag on the play.
Legal procedure on Midland. It's going to be the call. It's going to set him back 5 yards. It's a big 5 yards. Set of fourth and six. It'll be fourth and 11. That hurts, Coach. Takes away a few.
It takes away a lot of short plays. Now you're looking at screen. You're looking at a deep post.
We'll get it to Money or Warren and have
they're
make
all over
a play.
Here.
Mettner fires downfield to nobody.
Passes at the plate.
He just had to throw it up under pressure, and the Dow High defense makes the stand.
Now, Midland does not have timeouts. So at a minute and 40, the game's pretty much over. You can run it out.
I was going to take a knee here.
You can run it out.
So what a game we have had here tonight.
Fantastic game. And remember, my very first key to the game for Midland, you have to score 30 points. You have to score because Dow will score around 30 points or more.
Yep.
They did all the other things. They limited possessions. Their special teams have been fantastic. And, you know, Dow's big play offense has just kept them alive all night.
That's really what's done it. Their
Midland's game plan was fantastic. They kept themselves in the game. They allowed themselves a chance to win. They had a chance to win. Big penalty here at the end forced them to go. The 11-yard differential is big.
Yeah. And got to give Dow that credit. I mean, Midland came down with that big drive to take the lead, and Dow responded immediately. Really, one of the more exciting Midland-Dow games we've had in a while.
Been an excellent game, excellent game. Both teams played their hearts out.
Man's going to run it. Surprised he didn't just take a knee.
Exactly.
Kind of risk fumbling it there.
Yes, exactly.
Bruce Mann.
We ran the clock out with a minute and 40 with three quarterback sneaks.
Yeah.
And quarterback sneak, everybody piled on. By the time they unpiled us, okay, now we're going to run another quarterback sneak in 40 seconds, 35 seconds, and just ran the clock out.
Well, that's true. Instead of takes up more time than just taking a knee.
Right. Really. Don't take a knee because then they just start the clock again. We just ran quarterback sneak.
We're under a minute now. Now it's going to call time out.
Dow High takes their second time out of the second half.
So barring a catastrophe for Dow, they're going to improve to 8-1 in the season. It's been a good run here for the Chargers.
Well, thank goodness, because I did not want to drive up to Traverse City. And, you know, you can say all you want about the color tour. I'm not interested.
You just want to see some color right down
here. Right
here.
I want to
good
sit
old
right,
Midland.
I want to sit right here in this chair and enjoy the game next week. Friday night football. Good effort by Midland. Outstanding effort.
Really was. This was anybody's game right down to the wire. Time they do take the knee. And they're going to chop it. They're under 40 seconds. Clock is just going to run. Obviously, disappointing result for Midland. But certainly nothing to hang your heads on. Just what a battle.
And the ball is down again. Bring the final score. Dow High 26, Midland High 22. Enjoy your evenings and a safe trip home.
So the clock will run on this one. And the Chargers, congratulations, Coach Watson and all the coaching staff, seniors, the whole team, take the 2016 city championship game 26-22, the third straight title for the Chargers. Midland, meanwhile, end their year at 4-5, one game shy of a winning season.
Great game, though. Great game.
Yep.
Midland played fabulous.
Midland got some players healthy and had a full compliment tonight. This was just a back and forth even game. A study in contrast between the two teams. But we'll take a look at some of the highlights from the contest as the two teams shake hands.
This is Spencer Stevenson going little juke step and then good stiff arm and now into the end zone.
Wouldn't be denied then. That was early in the second half. Brought Dow to within one.
Long pass downfield. This is the interception.
Yep. And then try to go with the big play there, but it was picked off. it was the second turnover of the half for Midland. This was where Midland took the lead late
right
in the game.
Here, this is really a great play by Midland.
Found Walker, who took it in and gave Midland the lead with a little over 6 minutes to go. And then went for two. Metner did a good job looking left, looking off the defense, finding the receiver to the right. Was get good. And that gave Midland that 3-point lead. And then Dow responded, though. They marched down the field, and here's Spencer Stevenson, the tremendous football player, took it in for the winning touchdown for the Chargers. A lot of heroics today, Coach. I mean,
wow.
You know, we said this before when you talked about during the luncheon that in the big game, the best players need to play their best. It happened
exactly.
For both teams.
It happened for both teams.
I mean, Walker, Metner, Warren for Midland, all had and Landis had great games. Meanwhile, Dow, Cook, Stevenson, across the board, it was just a great football game.
Well, the difference is, see, I thought Midland played inspired football. I did not think Dow played inspired football, except Bruce Mann is a difference maker.
Yeah.
And he came out. How many third down plays did he convert?
Yeah.
That made the game worth, you know, in Dow's favor. And then the big plays that he made.
Yeah.
The big runs he made.
And so
no, I think Dow escaped this game. I mean, yeah. I got to tell you, I think that they escaped a very motivated, enthused Midland team. But Dow again has playmakers.
Yeah, playmakers.
You know, they have playmakers, and their playmakers played.
And so congratulations, Coach Watkins and his staff talking to his team. They will continue on next week. Most likely it'll be right here at Midland Stadium as they head on to the playoffs. Meanwhile, the Chemics season will come to an end. An up-and-down year for Midland High. They had some great victories, the Mount Pleasant game, so forth.
You can't lose playmakers.
Yeah.
I mean, you saw it tonight. I mean, they had money. They had the younger Walker.
Right.
You know, they lose a Sam Bokel,
yeah,
who is a great player for them.
Yeah, and so. But we'll wrap it up the regular season again. This is Dave Marsh bringing you the action with Frank Aldemore, and just been another really enjoyable season bringing you the action. Thanks to all the volunteers from the MCTV crew out there with this great service to provide our community. And we'll hope to bring you some playoff action down the road as well. But final score tonight, the Dow High Chargers 26, the Midland Chemics 22. Dow High, the 2016 city champs. Good night, everybody. We'll see you next time.